Hey guys, today I've got 5 super easy and simple music video effects that are super dope, and all of that under 5 minutes, so let's start. For the first one, you want to take the song that you're going to lip sync to and add some time remapping to it. Make some parts go faster, other parts slower, and perhaps even in reverse. When you start shooting your music video, you play back that song and try to lip sync with the different speeds. For the reverse part, you're going to definitely have to practice that a little bit. In Premiere Pro, you then place your shots in a timeline with the normal music track underneath. The parts where the music was slowed down, you speed back up to normal. So if you had a music part at 200% speed, that now becomes 50%. And the same goes for the reverse part, you just reverse that again to bring it back to normal. And that gives you a fun music video where your voice is synced to the music, even though that some shots are time remapped.
Oh, it's fine showing the smallest of things, that is what we found in you. Oh, 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 you a joy.
Effect number 2, buckle up, because this one is going to be very complicated. What you want to do is take a box where you can stand on, place your camera on the ground, and now stand with your heels on that box so that your feet are floating above the camera. And this creates that typical low angle effect that you see in rap videos. Now here comes the complicated part. In Premiere Pro, you drag your clip into the timeline. And that's it.
Sinning on the low like you added slick. Darkness make you disappear like a magic trick.
Effect number 3. Film your talent in a medium shot and make sure that he keeps his head and shoulders still. Next, we're going to take another shot from a different location, but a little bit wider. And you can make as many shots as you like, just remember to always make each shot a tiny bit wider. In Premiere, place your first shot on the bottom and on top of there the second shot. Set the top clip to 50% opacity, which allows you to scale and reposition it to match with the bottom clip. Then set it back to 100, then continue doing this for all the shots that you have. And that's the reason why every following shot is a little bit wider, so that you have the room to scale up and reposition each clip. Now once done, you can add cuts on the beat or whatever you want, and that's basically it, giving you seamless cuts between the different locations.
All I see is devils.
No, 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 no.
All that I see, all that I see is just devils.
Now, not only effects or camera tricks contribute to a great music video, I think the most important is still story and cinematography, which Isaiah Surrett teaches in his class about crafting your vision for music videos. This is a Skillshare class, and I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring today's episode. Now, in this class, he talks about how to vision an idea and turn that into a mood board. It's a very unique class, and I can highly recommend it to anyone who's about to start on a new music video. And the great thing about Skillshare is that with an active subscription, you can watch thousands of classes on the platform. Including mine. Recently, I published an advanced class for Adobe Premiere Pro, as well as a class for editing in Teams, which I'm both very excited about. Now, if you click the first link in the description down below, I can give out a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership for a limited time. After that trial, it costs less than $10 per month, so definitely make sure to check it out. Effect number 4. We're going to take a wide shot of a wall, and I'm going to bring that into Premiere Pro. On Storyblocks, I searched for a stock photo of some graffiti. Place your shot in the timeline, and on track number 3, we're going to make a wide circle and animate it so that it opens up at the point where Jill punches the wall. Now on this circle, I'm going to apply the roughened edges effect, and you can change the settings to your likings to get a more grungy edge. Now place your graffiti shot on track 2 and apply the track matte effect to it. And this allows us to select video track number 3, which holds the animated circle, and use that as the mask. Finally, change the blending mode of the graffiti layer to soft light to make it part of the wall, and that's it. And this brings us to the last music video effect, which is also going to be practical. What you want to do is set up 2 or more lights around your subject, and you want to have these lights as much as possible from the sides. Now, if you don't have film lights, you can also use anything else available, like some standing lights from the living room. As we play back the song, ask some friends to turn the lights on and off to a specific beat. And the faster you can do this, the better the result will look. You know, at one point, we even just randomly flicked the lights, and it turned out pretty cool. Hope that you've learned something new today, guys. Big thanks to Skillshare for the support. Thank you for watching. And as always, stay creative.
So we just took some takes with pouring water.